Good morning, children. Today it is lecture 6 under thermal properties of matter. In the last class we have learned three expansions. So during the expansion, thermal expansion, we have learned three types. One is linear expansion, second one superficial expansion, third one cubical expansion. So these three things we have learned. Along with that we have learned the mathematical expression, its definitions, as well as its SI units and CGS units. All these things we have learnt in the last class, okay? And also have given some the one very simple way to write superficial and cubical expansion with the help of linear expansion. So hope you understood very clearly. You feel very easy to learn the things. At the same time, you can write very easily as and when you come across this question in the exam. Okay? Now today let us go for the new concept where using the linear and superficial as well as cubical expansion, today let us learn how they are related with one another. How these linear expansion is related to superficial expansion, similarly linear expansion is related to cubical expansion. So today let us learn the relation between alpha, beta and gamma. Also we call it as relation between linear expansion, superficial expansion and cubical expansion. This expression you get for 3 marks in the exam, 3 marks for derivation. If you get the 3 mark question, I said already, if you get part C question, you expect this for 3 mark. By chance, if you get problems, at that time, based on this concept, you get some of the questions. So, depending on this, you should be very clear to learn as and when you come across this concept. Okay, alright. Let me go for the relation. Relation between alpha, beta and gamma. I said this is very important for 3 mark question. So be prepared to derive this for theory paper. If you get problems, you have to use this condition as and when you come across this question. Okay? Right. Now, to start with, I just give the hints where we already learned the linear expansion concept. First, I'll write the expression. I'm using that and how I'll use for the superficial as well as for cubical expansion. So, let me tell you, to write the linear expansion, we have this formula. Where L is equal to L dash is equal to L into 1 plus alpha delta t. This concept we have learned in the previous class. What is this L? L is said to be original length. L dash new length after expansion. Means after heating you get an expansion, that new length is L dash. And what is this alpha? It is a coefficient of linear expansion. And also we know there is delta T that explains rise in temperature. So during expansion means during heating expansion takes place. So during heating there is a rise in temperature. The temperature is represented by delta T, a small rise in temperature. Whenever there is a small rise in temperature, there is a small change in its length and that is occurring expansion. That new length is taken as L dash. This we have learned in the last class. Hope you understood this. So let me write here, what is this L called as? This L is original length. Original length. What is L dash? New length. And this alpha, it is coefficient of linear expansion. Linear expansion. delta T. This delta T is rising temperature. Rising temperature. Okay, so this is what we have. Now, let me start with, we have a cube. Its expansion, its length, original length is L, and the new length, if it is only increased with linear expansion, it is L dash. At that time, we got this expression. Okay, so let me write the one. Consider the cube, and that cube is of length L, original length. After expansion, you get L dash, and we get the equation, this one. Okay, so I write first this. L dash is equal to L into 1 plus alpha delta T. This is taken as equation number 1. The same cube, if you are explaining with respect to area, what do you mean by area? It is length and breadth. So if that cube, which is expanded on two sides, maybe length and breadth, the expansion takes place, we say area expansion. So for your reference, I write where original, that is A is equal to, that is L is A is equal to, I write L square. Is it clear? What is this L? L is length. If this length into length is nothing but it is length into breadth will give area. If I rewrite for the, that is nothing but called as A dash, then at that time I write N dash square. I think you are familiar with this concept. Okay? Sometimes, if the cube is heated and that is expanded from all directions, length, breadth and height, all the three sides of the expansion takes place, I give that as nothing but called as the volume. So now I write in terms of V. So please observe where V is equal to L cube. And suppose if the expansion takes place, L dash cube means it is none other than V dash. So hope you understood these things. The one condition I am using now, I will get the direction. So please observe this. Now what I just do is, I use the length of the cube, and that length, whenever it is the equation 1 is explained for the expansion after heating. So using this expansion, I just square this. But when I square it, you get nothing but called as area. So let me square this equation on both sides. So first I write squaring equation 1 on both sides. On both sides we get. Okay. What do you get? On both the sides I am squaring. Okay. So let me write here. This is L dash square is equal to L square. This will be 1 plus alpha delta T whole square. Both the sides are square. Nothing I am doing. This derivation very simple. Only by using this equation and I am using these are the conditions. If I use it, you will get the one final expression, relation between alpha, beta and gamma. And it is only mathematics here. There is no difficulty. Everyone can solve without any difficulty. So please observe. You need not muck up this. You need not bahat. You can just go on deriving this only by using the help of mathematics. Now, I know this is of a form that is a plus b whole square here. This is inside the bracket. This I rewrite as it is. So I just write L dash square is equal to L square. This will be A plus B whole square. Please observe A plus B formula. I write here. This is A plus B square means A square plus B square plus 2AB. This is the one formula we have in mathematics. I take the help of this. I write here. So what is A here? This is as A. This is as B. So let me say this is A, this is B, this term is B, this term is B. Now what shall I write? This 1 square will become 1 itself plus this B square means alpha square delta T square. Okay, plus 2 into 1, 1 into this much means it will become 2 alpha delta T. Hope you have written this correctly, right? Using that formula. Now I have written this formula here. In this case, please observe where here I write L dash square and L square. I substitute this with the help of this. I substitute here. So I write here this is nothing but a dash. This is equal to a. This will become 1 plus alpha square delta t square plus 2 alpha delta t. This is our expression. Remember, this alpha is coefficient of linear expansion. It is very small. That will be having very small value. But when you say it is very small, if you just the one square it, then it will be too small. So when you square this alpha, it is too small. Since it is very negligible value, we higher orders will be neglected. So I just take this condition which is very small, which is neglected. Means we are not taking into account because alpha square delta t square is small. So I write alpha square delta t square is very small. Is very small, therefore it is neglected. It is neglected. Right? I think you have understood this. Now if I write this, this is has been neglected here. When you are neglecting, that means now I rewrite this new formula where a dash is equal to a into 1 plus 2 alpha delta t. Okay, this is 1 plus 2 alpha delta t. Here, just observe, this is the one expression you have, that is 1 plus 2 alpha delta t. What is this 2 alpha? For this 2 alpha, I write the formula as where a is equal to a into 1 plus, for this 2 alpha, I write beta into delta t. This I have written in the previous class. In the last class, I have written this, where 2 alpha is represented by beta. What did you write? Let me write for your convenience. This is equation number 2. This is equation 3. What do you understand? By equating 2 and 3, we know that since 2 alpha is equal to beta. This 2 alpha is equal to beta. I have given the name 2 alpha as beta here. So we got, wherever you have 2 alpha, I am writing it as beta. So this is nothing but called as beta. Right? Now you got this equation. Now we got, that is area formula. Right? So this is how you write first this area. Okay. Let me go for the next step. Now we have completed area. Now let us go for the one. The same cube. When it is heated, it is expanded from all the three sides. So I take the one condition, this equation 1, and I just cube it on both the sides. So let me take the equation 1 and cubing equation 1. Cubing equation 1 on both the sides. On both the sides we get. So please observe, this is the one equation. I am cubing this on both the sides. First I write the equation. L dash cube is equal to L into 1 plus alpha delta t. I cube this both the sides. Right? This is the one equation we have. That equation 1, I am cubing it on both the sides. Now let me open this one. Now let me have this formula. You have, this is a plus b whole cube. Remember, I write formula here, a plus b whole cube formula can be written as a cube plus b cube plus 3ab plus 3a square b square. This is the one formula we have for a plus b whole cube, right? Now, for this, what I just do is, I write this formula now, that is l dash cube is equal to l cube. Here, this will become a cube, means this is 1 plus, what is b cube? Alpha cube delta t cube. Right? Plus 3 a. A means 1, this is into alpha delta t. So, 3 into 1 into alpha into delta t. Okay? Plus 3 a square, this is 1 square. 1 square will become 1 itself. Into b square, this is alpha square delta t square. Let me close the bracket now. So we got this expression using this formula, a plus b whole cube formula. Now, I just rewrite once again, l dash cube is equal to l cube, this is 1 plus alpha cube delta t cube plus 3 alpha delta t plus 3 alpha square delta t square. So, this is the one formula we have, right? Already in the previous equations I said alpha is very small. Naturally, alpha square delta t square is very small. But now, in this, again we have one more concept, that is alpha cube. Already alpha square delta t square is very small. Here I have taken this condition. Here I have shown where it is. This alpha square delta t square is very small. Here I have shown. Right? This is what I have shown here. Now, already we have this. This is very small. We understand this. But here, one more we have extra. Alpha cube delta t cube. That is also still small. Because we have square, it is cube. So, let us write. Now, first point. Let me write. Since alpha square delta t square and alpha cube delta t cube are very small. Very small. They are neglected. They are neglected. I think now you got this concept. Because first of all I said that condition. Now one more is added here. So both have been neglected. So both have been neglected means here this is one and this is one. Both are neglected. Then what is left out? I should write down. So I write L dash Q is equal to L cube into 1 plus, here only left out is 3 alpha delta t, remaining all have been neglected. Okay, now let me give the number, this is 3. Now let us make the condition here, this is for your convenience, let me write this is 4. This is 4. So what should I write now? Already v cube, no, L cube. L cube is nothing but v. Here, have given the name as v. Their L dash cube is V dash. So I just pre-write the formula, I take the help of this and write V dash is equal to V into 1 plus, here I write for this as gamma delta t. That is equation number 5. So from 5, it is from 4 and 5, 4 and 5, we know that where it is gamma is equal to 3 alpha. Gamma is equal to 3 alpha. We got gamma from 4 and 5. If you observe, it is understood where gamma is equal to 3 alpha. Here we have gamma, here we have 3 alpha. So it is understood now. So now we got the next equation. This is equation number 5 and equation number 3 and equation number 1. By just observing, by equating, that is equation 1. This is 1, we have equation 1. So from 1, 2 and 3. I am just only equating for alpha, beta and gamma. So, from above equations, alpha is to beta is to gamma is equal to 1 is 2. That is, alpha is 1, beta is 2 times of alpha and gamma is, this is alpha is alpha itself and beta is 2 alpha and this is 3 alpha, right? From equating this, therefore alpha is to beta is to gamma is equal to 1 is to 2 is to 3. This is what we come across here, where alpha is to beta is to gamma is equal to 1 is to 3, right? So this is how you are just deriving the equation for the one alpha, beta and gamma. And I said this is for 3 marks and this equation is very simple. You need not worry that is very difficult because already in the previous class I have explained how to get linear expansion, superficial and cubical expansion. So now you are not deriving that. You are only taking the help of only the linear expansion. That equation, only that equation you are taking, you are not supposed to derive. Let us start from this linear expansion expression itself. To derive this for 3 mark, because you had to just write for only 3 mark, you had to shortcut the things, you need not elaborate the things. So please observe, time factor is very important. You can start from this equation. So that is equation 1, length. Now what you are doing first step? You are getting that equation 1, and that equation 1 is squaring on both the sides. When you square it, you get nothing but called as L square, that is none other than called length into breadth, where you can take each length is L, therefore L square, that is nothing but area. We get for area. Okay, similarly, the same length you are taking, and that is equated for, that is, you are doing this because you know length into breadth into height, where each length is L, L into L into L is nothing but L cube, due to which you get this equation. Okay, now when you equate this, you get that is nothing but gamma, where is nothing but for the 1V, you are getting this equation. This is for 1. So now, after getting all these equations, finally you are equating the one above equations, you get alpha is to beta is to gamma is 1 is to 2 is to 3, where you get this expression. This is how to derive for 3-1. So it's very important. Please remember for the derivation. By chance, if you do not get derivation, then you have some problem. Sometimes they give the condition, the one problems using giving linear expansion. Therefore, I say to calculate the one cubical expansion. At that time, you are just taking alpha is 1 means gamma will be 3 times of alpha. Using this condition, they just give alpha value, calculate the cubical expansion. They say at that time, you use it. Sometimes in the one they give alpha and they say to calculate the one superficial expansion, at that time you take beta is equal to 2 alpha. So it is understood the one by knowing what of the value can calculate for superficial cubical expansion only by knowing linear expansion by using this method. Hope you understood this, and whenever you come across any objective type question or any 5-mark problems, if you get in between these conditions, you better remember this relation where it is 1 is to 2 is to 3. This is how you have to remember for the one relation between alpha, beta and gamma. Okay, now let me go for the next part in this, where today let us learn one more new concept after learning this derivation. Okay, in this thermal expansion, I just want to say one more condition. What is that means? In the previous class, I said about volume expansion. So, whenever you get a solid substance or maybe the liquid substance, expansion takes place, I said. So, with the cubical expansion, you know, so solids and liquids have given yesterday example, where the solids have given the example of copper, and also the one example for liquids I gave mercury and alcohol. So, and also remember the solids, I have given the example of inbar material. So, these are the examples we have learned yesterday. Today, let me give one more concept where during the volume expansion, how solids and the one liquids expand, due to expansion, what happens to its density. So, that density expression we come across here. Remember, you will get for the problem section the relation that you need for the one maybe object type questions or maybe for theoretical questions, you need that relation. Now I show that mathematical expression, which is very simple, right? Now let me go for the next concept, that is variation of the density with temperature. This is variation of density with temperature. expect for objective type questions? Objective type questions you expect, maybe sometimes you expect for obtain the expression for relation in density with the temperature. Maybe if you expect, you may expect for 3 months. So both you have to remember. So please observe, this expression is very simple. I'll give the very small hints, and using that you can derive without any difficulty. Now, density. So please observe, this is explained for the one solid substance, even for liquids also. So density comes for both solids as well as for liquids. So let me say, here today we are explaining for the variation of density with the temperature, I said. This I am explaining this concept whenever you are heating it. So during heating, what happens? The solid expands. So naturally, the one expansion takes place, what happens to its density as there is a rise in temperature. Suppose if you take liquid in a container, when you heat it, expansion takes place, nothing but volume expansion for a liquid. Naturally, that liquid will be having density. As and when you rise the temperature, density also changes. Naturally, the one temperature with respect to density. These things we come across for both solids and liquids, particularly both for solids as well as for solids and liquids, we come across the one density function. This you come across the one called as density. What do you mean by density? Density means it is the ratio of mass by volume. So please observe, density can be represented by, that is, mass by volume. Mass by volume. So for your convenience, I write the definition, the symbol for density is rho, and this is m by volume. Mass is represented by m and volume is represented by v. So density with respect to the one volume. Right? Now let me rewrite for the one in the, just by taking the concept of, here I said volume. So let me take the help of volume expansion, because this we have learnt in the last class, the one volume expansion. Directly I take the help of volume expansion equation. What is it? Where we know that volume expansion, that is V dash, is equal to V into 1 plus gamma delta T. This is the expression we have yesterday. Just now, even for the relation also, we have used this expression. So V dash is equal to V into 1 plus gamma delta T. What is this V? Where V is called as original volume. What is V dash? The new volume. Okay. So let me write where V is original volume. Original volume. What is V dash? New volume. Right. Now when you have original volume, let me take for the original volume, original density. That original density I represent by rho, where this is called as original density. I take the help of the density for original volume as rho itself. What about for new volume? I take rho dash, that is new density. This new density. When do you get this? This is original volume. Before heating you get this. This is before heating. Before heating you get it. This is after heating. After heating you get new volume. So now the similar concept you write. This is before heating. Before heating. This is after heating. That you have got density after heating, this new density. Right? This is the condition you have to follow now. Nothing to worry, very simple. Whatever you have taken this condition, for V you have taken rho. What is this volume rho? That is rho. Rho is nothing but density. Original density for original volume. This new density for new volume. Hope you understood this. How you got new volume? New, that is original volume. This you know from the previous class. Before heating, you got the original volume. After heating, expansion takes place. The, for that you have given the name as V dash, and that is new volume. Similarly, you have done this, right? Now let me go for the next part. Now you already know what is the condition. So you know the formula for this density is equal to mass by volume. Let me rewrite this formula for V. If I write it for V, I take the hypotenuse B is equal to m by b. Right. Now, similarly, if you want to write for b dash, right, m by rho dash. Mass remains same. Mass does not change. Here, nowhere I said about mass. Mass remains constant. Only the density varies. So, remember, this mass remains constant. Only density and volume are variables here. This remains constant. So, using this, I write for this condition. And you know for the new volume, density, this is for original volume. What about for new volume? For new volume, we know V dash is equal to M by rho dash. This is for new volume. Right? Now I take the help of this. Now using this equation I write, this is M by rho dash. This is M by rho. Here this is 1 plus gamma delta T. Right? Now in this case, if I just cancel M and M, because mass is same, mass remains constant. But these two are different. You cannot cancel them. Rho are different. So I write 1 by rho dash is equal to 1 by rho into 1 plus gamma delta t. Right. Now this is the one denominator. I want to take this to the numerator. What shall I do? I just rewrite. When I want to take this to numerator, then I can rewrite the equation like this. This is, I take this as rho equal to rho dash, this will become rho dash, this is rho into 1 minus 1 plus gamma delta t to the power of minus 1. I think you are able to catch this, because these two are in the denominator. I made them two for numerator. Already this was in numerator. Now I put it as to the power of minus 1. Means I am taking to this one, to the one nothing but I am doing this. This is the, now it will come to denominator, but that will be written in terms of to the power of minus 1. Hope you understood this equation. Right. Now, this equation, after using the binomial expansion, finally, you need not derive the binomial expansion. By the help of binomial expansion, you take this equation. There also we come across the one expansion takes place, it will come under squares, also cube after every term. But remember, this one lowest term will be kept up, the one higher orders are neglected. So at that time, we take that is of the form binomial expansion it is. So taking the help, with the help of, by using binomial expansion, by using binomial expansion, expansion means now this is of the form 1 plus x to the power of, that is 1 plus x plus n, 1, this is x plus n to the power of minus 1 it is. Okay, that is nothing but it is power is raised. So 1 plus x it is, x to the power of n it is. I have taken this condition as n. So you are ready to write, this is of the form 1 plus x to the power of n condition it is, like this. So when you are taking this condition, you get it. That is 1 plus n x to the power of n minus 1 plus n square x to the power. The higher orders would be like this. Yeah, like this. Okay. So now with the help of that, I just write. This is the condition where rho dash is equal to rho into 1 minus whatever the new one term you have. That you take. Here we have n. That will be taken here n. But here it is positive, I have taken positive. If it is negative, I should take negative here. So this is negative here. I take 1 minus gamma delta t. So this is the expression we have for the new density. Alright? So we got this expression. What do you observe from this expression? Here you can observe the one density. Expanding, you get the one density. Where now the new density goes on decreasing. After expansion, the density decreases. Because we have got the term in between minus, hence it goes on decreasing. This is the expression we have for the variation of density with temperature. So this expression we have to prove. I think it is very simple. So please observe. Today we have learned the variation of density with the temperature. To explain this density, that we are only explaining in terms of volume expansion, particularly in solids and liquids. So solids and liquids we come across density. But what do you know by density? Density is nothing but mass by volume. Since from school days you know that is density is mass by volume. So now I have written this formula, O is equal to mass by volume. So I have written instead of density symbol as rho. This mass as m, this is v. In this, remember, mass remains constant. Mass does not change, but only the one density and volume are variable. These two are variable. So I have written here. Now the formula I rewrite for this, where v is equal to m by. Now with the help of this again I write for v dash. V dash is equal to m by rho dash. M remains constant. Now by the help of these two, v and v dash, I rewrite this for this formula. I am substituting this. Finally, this m and gets cancelling because both are same, but these are different. So this will become 1 by rho dash. This is 1 by rho. This is as it is 1 plus gamma delta t. Nothing I am doing, I am keeping it as it is. Okay, right now. Now this rho dash is taken to numerator and this rho is taken to numerator. Now this is nothing but reciprocal we have, that is taken to numerator. But this will go to denominator because this will go to numerator means this will come to denominator. But that I have written in terms of to the power of minus 1. Now this is the one final expression you have. But now with the help of binomial expansion and by using the binomial expansion, we can rewrite this formula. This is the one expression for the one variation of density with temperature. So today we have like one more equation where it is variation of density with temperature. Right? Now one more point here. Today we have learnt the relation between alpha, beta and gamma and this derivation. Now I just give some salient point, that is neat points. Whenever you come across any objective type questions, you come across this. So I will give the one, the expression for the one neat points. Okay, now let me tell you what is it. While observing the expansion, thermal expansion, you have observed whenever the object has been heated, it expands. Whenever the temperature is decreased, nothing but you are cooling, that contracts. This concept you understood from the last class. So expansion and contraction takes place only there is a variation in temperature. If you increase the temperature, if you rise the temperature, naturally expansion takes place. If you decrease the temperature, naturally there is a decrease in temperature due to it, you get the contraction. This you know very comfortably. Now let me give this example for the one called as the pendulum clocks. Where you know in the one early days you are using pendulum clocks. Nowadays you are using quartz watches. You also have seen pendulum clocks. In that the pendulums, particularly those pendulums are made up of different types of materials. Different types of materials will be there. So these pendulums during winter, because different types of materials I said, so due to expansion during summer and during winter there is a contraction. So as the season changes, summer and winter, naturally there may be expansion and contraction takes place. That will affect our time. So what happens during summer due to expansion, naturally length increases and hence you can say time also increases, and due to which the one variation, that one time will be shown. Naturally during contraction means it will also decrease the temperature, due to which contraction takes place. Naturally there it also shows change in the temperature, change in the time. So this will affect our day to day life. So there is a, sometimes you will feel that pendulum clocks, sometimes they go very fast, they go slow. The due to what reason? due to the as the season changes, there will be change in the temperature. The temperature also affects this pendulum clocks. So sometimes you gain the time, sometimes you lose the time. Means, so due to the fast movement, due to slow movement, naturally there is a gain and loss of time. That is observed now. So let me tell you, as the temperature increases, what happens? Temperature increases, expansion takes place. Due to expansion, what happens? The length increases. So it will take more time. That is, length increases means the, you can say, when the temperature increases, the pendulum also will, the time period of the pendulum will also increase with time. So pendulum also increases with the time means what happens? The clock loses time. So during summer, I tell you, temperature increases. So during summer, temperature increases. During winter, what happens? Temperature decreases. So naturally, temperature increases means the pendulum increases with the time. Pendulum increases with the time. Pendulum increases with time means what? It loses time. It loses time. Right? There is a loss of time, I can say. It loses time, we can say. It's a loss of time. Right? Similarly, naturally, the clock loses time, I can say. That is nothing but the pendulum clock loses time. Very simple, I write. Clock. Clock loses time. What loses time? Clock. Clock loses time. Now, during winter, temperature decreases. Right? Temperature decreases means what happens? Pendulum decreases with time. Means what? Nothing but here, this is pendulum increases with time means expansion takes place here. This is expansion. Here this is due to which? That is contraction. Right. What happens here? Clock gains time. So clock gains time. I think you have understood what happens in during summer and winter. Clock gains time. So now this helps. What does it help now? Due to which the loss or gain of time. Now that can be calculated. You get some problems based with neat questions, maybe in Karnataka CET, maybe in JEE, in competitive exams, you get the question. At that time, you have to calculate the problem. At that time, you are using one formula. How to calculate loss or gain of time? That will be calculated using the one suitable formula. That formula you just remember where it is. Here time is delta t. Where delta t is equal to, where you can take half times of alpha delta t into t. What do you mean by this now? Where this is loss or gain, maybe increase or decrease of time. You are calculating loss or gain of time. What is this alpha? Alpha is called as coefficient of linear expansion. What is delta t? Rise in temperature. What is this t? This is time. Okay, so I write here, this is loss or gain of time. Loss or gain of time is calculated using this suitable formula where delta t is equal to half into delta t into t. Suppose if you are calculating this, the final loss or gain of time you are calculating. If you are calculating for one day, so when you are calculating for one day, then it is you are calculating for per day. What is the time? The time you can rewrite it as, when you want to write for per day, you are going to calculate per day, loss of time per day, loss and gain of time, loss or gain of time per day. If you want to calculate per day, then T is equal to, 1 day is 24 hours, 1 hour means 60 minutes and time is 60 seconds. So 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So everything is converted in seconds. You are using this for time whenever you are calculating for per day. Suppose if you are calculating for seconds, directly you use it. But remember, if it is for 1 day, 24 hours, and that hours is converted to minutes, again minutes are converted to seconds. So because we prefer to take SI system and time is always expressed in SI, that is in seconds. So we prefer to use this in the problem. This condition you just remember. So very simple, you need not go to get to confusion. Remember, because here whenever there is a summer, summer means actually temperature rises. That you know, temperature decreases. Temperature increases means what? Expansion takes place. So pendulum increases with the time. There is an increase in time with the pendulum clock. Whenever there is an increase in time means it is understood clock loses time. Means clock loses time. Similarly, during winter, temperature decreases. Temperature decreases due to what happens? There is always pendulum decreases with the time. There is a decrease with the time, it will go slow. So here fast, it will go slow. So fast, clock, that is increases with time means what? It moves fast. You can say fast. So here it moves slow. This you can say. So fast, sometimes our clock moves very fast. Sometimes it goes slow. That can be explained using this condition. What happens here? This is due to expansion. This is due to contraction. Right? Now, this is explained in terms of clock. How does it explain? Clock loses time. This clock gains time. When you contract, clock gains time. Whenever it loses time means, it is clock is nothing but where you can say that one where due to expansion. So these things you are, if you understand correctly, then whenever you want to calculate the one time, what is the time? Loss or gain of time if you want to calculate. This is the one standard formula. You just remember there, delta t is equal to half into alpha into delta t into t. This t is called as temperature. How much temperature it is, that is substituted here. This time, that is t. You are calculating for maybe 1 hour, 2 hours, maybe for the 1 day. At that time you are converting this. This is how you are calculating for the one for pendulum clocks. Okay, this today I have explained only one mean point. Now let me explain further mean points in the next class based on expansion. Let me stop today.